Deepfakes are hyper-realistic video, audio, or images of someone appearing to do or say things they didn't do or say. They're made using artificial intelligence, or AI. The term deepfake is actually a mashup of fake and deep learning, which is a type of AI algorithm. Until recently, only special effects experts could make realistic looking and sounding fake content. But AI algorithms make it possible for non-experts to create fakes that many people would deem real. The algorithm uses footage of two people, an impersonator and a person targeted for impersonation. It then generates a new video that shows the targeted person moving and talking in the same way as the impersonator. The result is a realistic looking and sounding forgery. Because deepfakes are so realistic, they can be used to humiliate and blackmail people and attack organizations. They could also incite political violence, unsettle diplomatic relations, and sabotage elections. An explosion of deepfakes could even cast doubt on videos that are real by making it easier for someone caught behaving badly in a real video to claim that the video was a deepfake. These dangers are made worse by how quickly and easily social media platforms can spread unverified information. If deepfakes are so dangerous, why aren't they illegal? One reason is because the technology to create them is developing quickly and the law hasn't caught up. Another reason is that this technology has positive applications. For example, it can help people with ALS make digital copies of their voice before they lose the ability to speak. So then what can countries do to prevent deepfakes from sparking conflict? First, countries must decide which uses of deepfakes are acceptable and which are not. This would help social media companies police their platforms for harmful content. Another thing countries could do is pass laws to allow internet platforms to share information about deepfakes. This would make it easier for platforms to alert each other to a malicious deepfake before it spread and warn news agencies before it infiltrated the mainstream news cycle. At a minimum, governments must fund the development of media forensic techniques that make it easier to detect deepfakes. So far, deepfakes have not been deployed to incite widespread violence or disrupt an election. But the technology to do so is available. That means there's a shrinking window of opportunity for countries to safeguard against the threats from deepfakes before they spark conflict.